In this tutorial, we will perform a very common transformation, taking non-spatial data in a CSV file and writing it out to a spatial format, in this case, Esri shape. Our CSV file lists cell phone signal measurements at various locations in the city of Vancouver. We have longitude, latitude, elevation, station ID, power, and quality columns. Let's create the workspace by opening FME Workbench. We'll select blank workspace in the Getting Started window. Drag the CSV file onto the canvas from Windows Explorer. In the Add Reader dialog, click on Parameters to see how Workbench will read this data. There is a file preview and a schema attribute section that show how FME will read the data. The schema attribute section specifically shows which data types FME will map the columns to. By default, a number data type is used for longitude, latitude, and elevation columns. But we can map them to X, Y, and Z coordinate columns so that FME will create points when the data is read. Click OK to dismiss the parameters. Set the coordinate system as longitude-latitude. After you click OK, a CSV feature type will be added to the canvas. Before we add a writer, let's confirm that the points really are created as the data is read. Right-click on the CSV feature type and select Connect Inspector. Run the workspace and it will open in the FME Data Inspector. Here we see that we do in fact have multiple points. Now it's time to add an Esri shape writer to our workspace. But first, let's remove that inspector from our canvas by highlighting it with our mouse cursor and hitting Delete on our keyboard. From the Writers menu, select Add Writer. Enter Esri shape for the format. Open the folder browser next to Dataset and select a folder in which to write the shapefile. We will stick with the default copy from reader for the shapefile definition. Click OK. Go ahead and connect the source feature type to the destination feature type. Expand the attribute list to confirm the proper attribute names were added. Notice that num_measures and recorded_tstamp are not properly mapped because the shape writer truncated their names on the destination. This is because the shape format has a 10-character limit for the attribute names. Expand the attributes on the source feature type. Connect the num_measures and recorded_tstamp to the truncated ones on the destination. Open the destination feature type properties. Let's change the name of the shape file to cell data. Change Allow Geometry's geometry to shape_point, then click OK. Run the workspace by clicking on the green play button. Right-click on the output and choose Inspect to open the newly created shapefile in the FME Data Inspector.